Hello and welcome! Grafana Champion is here. My name is Daria Volkova and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. This video is about our calendar plugin. After joining the business suite we're developing, we slightly changed its name. Please welcome the business calendar panel for Grafana. Different name with the same valuable and unique functionality for business applications. Let's review what this plugin offers and how to use it. Are you ready? Let's go! What does the Business Calendar plugin do? We designed it to display data in a calendar format. For many visual features, we use the Big Calendar library, an open source React library with a stylish, modern design and outstanding performance. To demonstrate the Business Calendar plugin better, I need some good data. For that, I will use the Grafana catalog data in JSON format. Let's quickly review how I set it up before diving into the business calendar options. For the data source, I use the JSON API data source, which I call API plugins. It connects to the grafana.api/plugins link to retrieve the Grafana catalog plugins data in JSON format. Here is the link in the browser. Detailed data on all existing Grafana plugins. Next, on the dashboard, I added the table visualization and titled it Grafana Catalog. Then I connected the API plugins data source. On the fields tab, I specified the JSON path for all data elements I would like to retrieve from the endpoints. I also added one transformation, organized fields by name, to have user-friendly names for the data elements of interest. I could have used the aliases from fields tab, but I can hide fields and shuffle the order using this transformation. Next, I switch to the table view to review the retrieved data frame. The key elements are the plugin name and update at. They are mandatory for a meaningful calendar visualization. The rest are optional. All right, the data is ready. Next, I add a new visualization. Select Business Calendar from the drop-down menu. The data source is dashboard, which means working with the data that has already been retrieved and is in Grafana possession. Source, the Grafana catalog panel, the table panel I just created a moment ago. Now I can dive deep into the Business Calendar options. I will start with the data section. Here I can see all data elements that the Business Calendar works with. I can point out which fields from the data frame should be mapped to the calendar fields. For instance, I map text with the plugin name, event description with the plugin description, location with the plugin version, event start time with the plugin latest update date, event end time I keep not populated. For labels, I use two fields, slug and version. The parameter colors expects a data field with an integer value. It is connected with the Grafana thresholds and is going to be used as a background color depending on the threshold you specify. For instance, I can use the number of downloads in the color parameter and then here specify that all plugins downloaded more than 1000 but less than 5000 times to have a yellow background. And downloaded more than 5000 times to have a green background. From here, I can say that the Run Reveal plugin has been downloaded less than 5000 times. I do not need this for further demonstration, so I remove the color field from here. The next section to review is Business Calendar. Here, I can set which time of the day the calendar visualization should always scroll to when opened. I set it to 9 a.m. With that, when I open my dashboard, the calendar will always show 9 a.m. at the top. The following section is Layout. Here I can select which layouts users are allowed to choose from on the dashboard. If I keep only day in this parameter, then on my dashboard, here users only see day. Let me add all available layouts and open the dashboard again. Here is what the day looks like. All events for the day, the calendar is scrolled to the configured 9 a.m. For the week, I see 7 days. Let me change the date to get different busy slot combinations. For the work week, I see 5 days. No Saturday, no Sunday. The month allows to review the whole month at once. The year shows a year calendar. The agenda keeps only the busy time slots and shows multiple days for the selected period. Let's get back to edit mode. Under the allowed views, I have the default view, the starting view for your calendar, which will be shown when the calendar opens. The following parameter, date and time format, is relatively new. It overrides the Grafana language configuration. If I go up here, click Profile and scroll down, here is the language setting. And if you didn't know, it also controls the date and time format. So this setting of the business calendar option overrides that one and in addition has two extra formats. I switch to the day layout to demonstrate. English 24. With that, you will see 16:00 instead of 4 p.m. and so on. And ISO 8601 is international standard. I will set back to English. Moving to the colors parameter. Events will ensure that all events are colored differently. For some reason, I still have threshold. Let me remove them. Go to the data section and remove the field name from the color option. Now all events are colored differently. To see what the frame does, you need at least two frames. In my example, I use the static data source to create two data frames. The plugin displays all events from one frame in the same color. Since I have two frames, my events are colored with two colors. Up next is the events section. Here you can control what the user click on the occupied time slot would do. The open link will open a page with an associated link. You can set up links in the data links section. I click the edit button to open the edit link window. Here I reference the data frame, column, fields, URL data element. The show details button opens a drawer. For instance, I click on the business news and here is what the drawer looks like. The elements shown are configured in the details info section. Here is the description, labels, links, location, text, and time. The only data element on the screen with the hard-coded title is location. If you need something specific, you can change the location title to anything you need. For instance, I change it to booth number. And there is the updated drawer. The annotation section controls the visibility of Grafana annotations on your calendar. To display them, you need to enable the option. You can further specify which types, alerts, or annotations you are interested in. The user can see the drawer for the alerts annotations as well. We have this video on our channel that explains alerts and annotations in great detail. Check it out for a deeper dive. Feel free to ask any alert annotation related questions in the comment section there. In addition to all I said, please note the latest version of the Business Calendar plugin requires a Grafana 10 or Grafana 11. This might be a breaking change for some users, so be careful when deciding on the upgrade. We are excited about the upcoming month. The business suite will combine solutions for many business aspects of the fully functioning web application. Business calendar, business charts, business text panel, business variable panel, business image panel, business forms panel, business table panel, business news data source. Stay tuned for upcoming videos and news. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.